Hi, it's Michael from Ponds by Michael Wheat. So, a question we get asked every now and again: can we create a swimming pond without plants in it? So, firstly, let me just talk briefly about what a swimming pool does. So a swimming pool obviously doesn't have any plants in it, and it can't, they die straight away. And the way that it's able to maintain that clarity of water is through chemicals, namely chlorine or bromine or whatever you want to call it, okay? Sometimes I hear people say, oh, there's a non-chlorine alternative, a salt alternative. Well, the salt alternative isn't a non-chlorine because the salt just ends up turning to chlorine. So actually, all swimming pools really have chlorine in them that get that clear water. So the swimming pond, how do we achieve that without having any chemicals in? And as you see with the videos of this pond that I'm stood next to right now, this has been in 3 years, the water could not be clearer. We actually hardly get any blanket weed in here as well. And you'll see there's only a tiny little section with a few plants in it, tiny footprint of the actual project. And I'll be frank, we don't need them. So in all our swimming pond projects, we don't need any plants. Now we put them in because aesthetically they look great. And of course we want them to look natural. This is more of a swimming pool type swimming pond build. But as you can see, the water in here could not be clearer. It's super clarity. And this is achievable through our system. Lots of different things in our system have to happen. It's not as simple as, oh, just go and whack a filter on it and the filter will sort the problems out and it'll get it clear. So to kind of list all the different types of management we do with water, we do a lot of water testing, water management. So we have pH management, we have GH, KH and carbonate hardness. We do a lot of dissolved oxygen type management. We do phosphate management, which is very important. We do the filter and the nitrogen cycle. We have the UVs as well. Water movement's key. So lots of things have a huge factor. And ultimately, all these results and all this research and development the company's done has come from not getting things quite right, us having to, at our own cost, add more equipment. And now, for the last 2 or 3 years, we've had an excellent run of delivering projects as they should be and with the absolute everything thought of. What I find is ponds that are built the traditional way and have the big gravel bed planting areas, what tends to happen is they fill a silt eventually. And unfortunately, because of that, you start to get ammonia and nitrites in the water, and then that's when you start to get a lot of blanket weed spikes. And from what I hear, the answer that every company has to why have I got loads of blanket weed is, oh, it's a bad year for blanket weed. Well, that's just absolute nonsense. There's not such a thing as a bad year for blanket weed. Blanket weed grows from food source in the water, which is phosphates and nitrates. And that's something that we do a lot of work on. So because we filter the water and use UVs, and you can't use UVs on a system that's been built with a gravel bed system, because what it does, it'll kill that bacteria in the gravel beds. Whereas in ours, the bacteria lives in the filters and the UV doesn't kill that. Because we've got the UVs on it, our water is clearer than any swim pond you get on the market in the world, because of how we deliver it and how we put it together. That is why our water clarity is the clearest. Now, the thing is, with water being so unbelievably clear, is that blanket weed grows easier because it's so clear. And then because of that, that's why we do so much phosphate management. But the other thing I'd like to also point out is that because our swimming ponds are clearer, they're actually warmer. Because what happens is the sun can penetrate it easier, the black liner soaks it up and actually makes the ponds even warmer. The water in the ponds, obviously. So, again, another huge advantage to how we build our projects. It's something that I'm massively passionate about. I love doing the water chemistry side of it, getting the chemistry right and seeing the great results that we get. And this is an amazing example of why plants aren't actually needed. So just to understand why people say plants need it. So I sometimes hear, well, plants do the filtering. Plants don't do filtering. So what plants do, the actual thing they do, is they take nitrate from the water. They will take phosphates from the water, but for them to be able to do that, the pH has got to be correct and the carbonate hardness has got to be spot on so that pH is stable. If it's not stable, basically they can't take phosphate from the water. That kind of really important information is something, in my opinion, is knowledge that's missed. And it's really important to actually achieving the goal. And with all of the projects we've ever delivered, I'm so keen on delivering exactly what the clients wanted, that crystal clear water. And if the clients ever feel they've not quite got that, I'll always go out and see them deal with it myself. So crystal clear water is our aim, is our goal. And as you can see with this, with hardly any plants in this swimming pond, we can achieve it. No chlorine needed. Perfect example of what we do. Thank you. I'm Michael from Ponds by Michael Wheat.